So today we're talking about comfort eating. So the reason I'm talking about that is that some of you might have seen it last week. I put a post in the group about what challenges people were having at the moment. And a few of you mentioned comfort eating as being the big one. And to be honest, it really isn't surprising. So the first thing I'm going to say about comfort eating is to really give yourself a break, cut yourself some slack. You know, it's part of it. It's almost, it is subconscious. You can't help it, because comfort eating, and we can also call it emotional eating, has got certain roots in us as human being that really we can't do much about it. So, for example, the time of year, I mean, it's winter, it's colder, it's grayer, and our body, we don't realize that our body uses a huge amount of energy purely to keep our body temperature up. So that's the most energy that the body uses. The most energy it uses on any given day is to keep our body temperature up. So when it is colder, it is normal to need more energy. And one of the ways we find that energy is in food. So that's why when it's colder, we all have a tendency, I'm pretty sure, to reach for, to eat a little bit more, to look for comforting food, to eat warmer food, such as the kind of stews and soups. And you know, those, I mean, I don't know you, but I really don't fancy eating a cold salad at the moment. You know, that's something that you will want when it's nice and warm in a few months' time, hopefully. At this time of year, there's a tendency to eat more, to eat warm stuff, because that's what our body needs, because it is colder. So if you've got a tendency to comfort eat, there is that to take into consideration. It is winter, so your body will want more energy, will need more energy, so there is that. The second thing is when there is a time of stress, and at the moment, unfortunately, you just have to switch the news on, there is stress, there is tension, there is stuff to be anxious about. And all of that causes a reaction. So when we feel stressed, basically, the brain tries to make you feel better. That's the one thing that's really interesting, is that our brain all the time wants us to feel good. So when we are faced with something challenging, the brain is going to look back and see, all right, okay, what worked? What makes her feel better? And for a lot of us, food is up there in the top two or three things that make us feel better. You know, I remember when I grew up in Belgium, my grandmother, whenever I hurt myself or I fell or I was upset, you know, immediately the box of biscuits would come out or the tart would come out or we'd go to the bakery and get something, you know. Food was there as a way to make me feel better. And I'm pretty sure that a lot of us have been raised like that, because you want to make somebody feel better. And, you know, at the time, I mean, she grew up, you know, before the Second World War, and for her, having food and being able to give food was a way to feel good. So I very much had that thing in my head that if I'm not feeling good, if I'm anxious, go for food, sweet food. I've got a very sweet tooth. So we might also have that when we are stressed, our brain will look back to what made her feel better before. And food, as I said, can be very high in the list. I mean, I remember years ago now when my mum passed away, I ate so many chocolate biscuits, it was ridiculous. And interestingly, thinking back to it now, actually, before this morning, as I was thinking of the life, I wasn't eating any chocolate biscuits. I was eating my favorite chocolate biscuits when I was a little girl. So talk about the brain going back and looking back at what made her feel better. I was eating little dinosaur-shaped biscuit, you know, age 30, eating little dinosaur-shaped biscuit covered in dark chocolate. And I ate that for days. I would have that pretty much constantly in my desk, in my bag, in the cupboards, because that's what made me feel better. That's what my brain was telling me to do. And when it is short, it's not something that we that usually we actually realize, because when we comfort eat for a very strong emotion, our brain usually is really focused on that strong emotion. And the comfort eating, we almost don't realize we're doing it. You know, we're aware that we're eating more, we're aware that we're always hungry and that we're always nibbling on something, but that's not what we're concerned about. What we're concerned about is the big thing at the front that has caused the comfort eating. And usually when it is that kind of circumstances, when that event either ends or that you start feeling better about it, like, you know, in a grieving process, when you start feeling a bit better about it, then the comfort eating naturally subsides and you don't feel that need anymore. So those are the two things that really, you know, it is winter, there is a lot to be stressed about. So those are two things that are could be at the root of your comfort eating. And the third one is boredom. When we are bored and we look for something to do and there is something to eat, it's very hard to resist that call of whatever it is that we have in the cupboard or in the fridge. So boredom also plays a big role. I know that some of you, you've commented back that for you it wasn't stress, but it was boredom. Or the other way around. It wasn't boredom the cause, it was stress. But those two, stress and boredom, tend to be high up when it comes to comfort eating. And the interesting thing is that stress and boredom both affect our energy in some way. When we are bored, we feel sluggish. Our energy is quite low because we are bored, because we have nothing to do, because we're not stimulated. When we are stressed, our energy is scattered all over the place and we don't have much energy for us. It's scattered and it needs food to, in a way, keep going. But that's not really the solution. The solution is to try and suggest to your brain another way of doing things. And one way of doing it is by raising your energy level. And I'm going to show you in a bit a sequence that is traditionally used before sitting in meditation, because it really harmonizes the energy in the body. But I found personally that it can be used to just reset your energy fully, to help you bring in something positive, to help you let go of the stress, to help you assimilate what is all around us, to help you with letting go of expressing what you might be holding of stress and anxiety, because there is a lot of that. There is a lot of, we feel things, but we don't let them out. They stay and they cause tension and they cause stress. And we want to release, and that's when we go for food. That's when the brain goes, okay, what can make her feel better? And it goes for food. So that sequence that we're going to do in a moment, you can really do it anytime. I mean, you'll see when I get up, I really am not in yoga clothes, but you can still do it in skinny jeans. It works. It's not really about the movements. It's all about, well, you'll see when we get to it. I'll stop talking about that. You'll see when we get to that. And I just wanted to share before we get onto the sequence, because I said, you know, that, I don't know if you've come across the post when I mentioned that I used to actually comfort eat quite a lot. And it's quite funny how you forget, because that was 13 years ago that I was really, well, 13 years ago I kind of stopped comfort eating. But before that, it was a habit. I mean, chocolate digestives were my favorite thing to go for. And there wasn't a day going by without me eating chocolate biscuits. I wasn't hungry, I just wanted to eat chocolate biscuits. And then something happened that broke that habit, and that's when I realized that it is a habit, is that I had to have a lot of dental treatment. I've got very bad teeth, and at some point, it was just the year after Lara was born, I needed to have quite a lot of crowns and stuff. And I had those very long dentist appointments. One of them was 4 hours long, think about that. And then I would come home and my mouth would be completely sore and I would have temporary feeling and temporary this and temporary that, which meant that really what I could eat was very limited. It was a lot of soup, it was a lot of porridge, a lot of juices, nothing crunchy. So the biscuits were out of the question. And that lasted for a good few weeks. I think that lasting for about 4 weeks before I could eat normally again. And that was enough to kind of break that pattern. So that was very extreme. That really wasn't the intention, but that was one of the good things that came out of having to get that much dental stuff done, is that it stopped me from munching on chocolate digestive like there is no tomorrow. Okay? Right, now I'm going to show you the sequence. So we're going to stand up, we're going to do the sequence, and it's all about raising your energy. So if the boredom is the cause of the comfort eating, it's going to alleviate that. If the stress is the cause of the comfort eating, again, it's going to alleviate that. And it's a sequence, as I said, that you can do anywhere, anytime. Personally, I like to do it in the morning. And sometimes, like mid-afternoon, when I feel a bit, that's when I reach for it as well. So if you want to come up, so as you can see, not at all yoga clothes, but it's going to work anyway. So we're going to come to stand with the feet hip width apart, as we usually do, knees soft, tailbone gently tucked under, and shoulders back. Good. And we're going to start by breathing in to lift the arms up. And as you breathe out, you float the arms down as low as comfortable. Take your hands behind the back. Breathe in to scan the back of the legs and place the hands in the lower back. Good. Breathe out. Arms coming down to the front. Breathe in. And you're uncurling, you're opening. Nice. Breathing out to come down. Breathing in to come up. And the whole idea behind this is to focus on the in-breath with breathing out to come down. And as you breathe in, you can breathing in plenty of oxygen. New oxygen, new energy into your body. Let's do one more round of that. So we're going to breathe out to come down. Take the hands behind, breathing in deeply as you come up. Opening the chest, allowing for plenty of oxygen to come in. Breathing out. And then one last time coming up. Breathing in, opening through the chest. Nice. We'll relax the arms. And you can probably feel already that you're feeling a lot more lively just after those movements. Now that was about taking energy in. Now we're going to focus on assimilating, because we take in more than food during the day. We take in any kind of information, energy around us, all of that, we take it in. But it might stay stuck somewhere and cause a lot of stress. So we're going to take the hands in front of the navel as if you were holding a ball. You're going to breathe in. And then we're going to breathe out, a quick out breath to one side. And then breathing in to come back. Breathing out to the other side. Breathing in. And again, breathing out. And in. Keep the knees soft. And you've got that little twist around the abdomen, around the navel. And that's all about assimilating, digesting, really, everything that we have around us. We'll go one more time to each side. Well done. Lovely. So that was about assimilating everything we take in. And now, as I was mentioning, sometimes we take a lot of it in, but we don't express it out and it stays stuck. So we're going to remedy that. We're going to take a little step forward in the hands at the level of the chest. You're going to breathe in and you're going to squeeze your shoulder blades. And as you breathe out, you're going to breathe out in two times. We're going to breathe out, sharp out breath first, but not a full one. And then out again as you come up a little bit. So we breathe in. And then first out breath, forward, and then pointing the sternum up, looking up. Good. Again. Nice. And that's all about lifting the energy up. Good. Coming back to hip width apart. Now we're going to let go. And this is one of my favorite parts of it. You breathe in. Not too much of a back bend, just lifting up. And then breathe out, focusing on letting go. Bending the knees if you want to have the hands on the floor. Just stay there for a moment. Just breathing out. Letting go. any tension, any guilt that you might have around the comfort eating, just breathing that out. Hands behind you, breathing in to come up to the back. Lovely. But we're not arching back this time, we're just coming back up. Breathe out, hands coming down to the front. Breathe in, coming up. Lovely. And then breathing out, focusing on letting go and relaxing the stress, the tension, letting it all go. Taking the hands behind, breathe in to come up. Nice. And again, breathing out, relaxing, letting go. Breathing in, up. Nice. We're going to come down one more time, breathing out, all the way down. And I'd like you to take your hands out as if they were wings of a bird that you're lifting. And then we're going to come up, arms out to the side, and then coming up to the crown of the head. Palms facing up. There you go, just above the crown. Good. And you can see a golden light, visualize a golden light falling on the palms of the hands. Turning the hands to face you and letting it go down. Showering your body with that golden light. Coming forward, all the way down. And let's do that again, breathing in. Arms coming out to the side and up. Take a moment to feel that golden light. And then take the hands down. Feeling the golden light washing over your body, washing away stress, tension, tiredness, taking all of that down. Lovely. One last time, breathing in, hands coming to the level of the heart. We're going to turn the palms to face up. And if you want, you can stand here, you can close your eyes, you can look ahead of you. And just feel into your body, feel into your heart. Breathing comfortably and having a sense of gratitude, of compassion to yourself. You're doing the best you can. If you want to change that comfort eating, you can, but just know that you don't have to. It's all up to you. Well done. Feeling a sense of love in the body, in the heart. And as you breathe out, feel that love going down your arms through the fingertips, sending it out. One more time, breathing into the heart. Love and compassion, breathing it out. Lovely. And taking the hands back into prayer. And relaxing your arms down. Good. So as you can see, that's not a long sequence at all, and I did talk a lot through it. So what I'm going to do at the end of this live chat, I am going to record the sequence without all of the explanation, just the flow of the sequence. And then I'll put that in the, I'll actually put that on YouTube. I'll put that on my YouTube channel and I'll send you the link once it's done. So you can access just the sequence if you want to do it more regularly. And as I said, you can probably feel it now. You know, that didn't take long and you can probably feel all your energy has shifted. You know, you can probably feel yourself being a lot more in your body. And yeah, I mean, I was really hungry before, actually, but I'm not feeling quite as hungry now, so, you know, hopefully it worked. So the whole point, the whole idea behind that is to shift your energy so that you do feel better and there isn't that need anymore to go for food. Because, as I said, comfort eating is a way of the brain to try and make you feel better. If you start getting into the habit of doing some movements, and that it makes you feel better, little by little, your brain is going to realize that actually that works. I don't need to go for the food. Okay? So that's a good one. That's a good way of doing it. And if you don't have the time to do the whole sequence, you can just pick one movement, like the first one of breathing in and breathing out, doing that a few times. Just that is enough to shift the way your energy is. And to make you feel better so that need to comfort eat is not quite as strong. So that's one thing I wanted to talk about. The other thing I wanted to talk about was that I really believe that it's all about balance. You know, I've stopped comfort eating about 13 years ago, but that doesn't mean I've stopped eating sweets and biscuits and cake, God forbid, no. I've got a very sweet tooth, I love baking as well. So the way I do that, and I'm throwing it out there because that might be useful to some of you as a way of looking at things, is that I kind of I'm good Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, I have my main meals, and if I want to snack, I snack on something healthy. Then Friday, Saturday, Sunday, there's no rules. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, if I want biscuits, if I want cake, I'll go for it. And there's no rules. And then come Monday, I'll be, you know, more careful and just eat healthily for 4 days, knowing that Friday, Saturday, Sunday, I can have what I want. And that works well for me, because I tried plenty of ways of, you know, curbing the way I was eating before. It never worked, because I always had that sense that, oh, I want this, I want that, and I can't have it. Whereas that I find really works, to have 4 days of being good, and then 3 days of doing absolutely what I enjoy. I think that for me, that really works. And that might be something that you might want to consider as well, as a way to keep the sugary stuff or the savory stuff, if you prefer, in your life. Because, you know, we're not talking diets or anything like that. I'm not at all into that. But if you find that your comfort eating is too much, as I said, maybe do the movements to help you curb that during a few days of the week. And then if you want to indulge, indulge. You know, life is supposed to be fun. If you want to eat the cake, eat the cake. And don't feel bad about it. And I know you might think it's easy for you to say because you don't have weight to blah, 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 blah. But believe me, I did. You know, I wasn't thin, far from it. This is probably the thinnest I've been in years. And I think a lot of that happened through that new balance I found between the days where I watch what I eat and the days when I really don't. So, in talking about eating as well, one thing that I thought about was that it's important to eat properly, because comfort eating might just be because you're hungry. So if you don't have breakfast, or if you tend to skip lunch, or to make it very, very small because you're busy, if you're at work or anything like that, maybe attend to that first. Because if you're hungry, genuinely hungry, your body will want food. So make sure that you've got a proper breakfast, that you've got a proper lunch, a proper dinner, before anything else. You know, check that before anything else. And also check that you drink properly. Because interestingly, our brain will send us the same signals of hunger, even if we're just thirsty. So even if you're just thirsty and you're not hungry, you will feel hungry. You will not feel thirsty, weirdly. So if you feel hungry, but you know you've just eaten and really you shouldn't be, see if you need just a drink. You know, have some water, have a cup of tea. God knows I drink a lot of tea. And that might just be it. You might just need to drink. Okay? So to recap, so number one, don't beat yourself up. Comfort eating is just a thing that your brain does to try and make you feel better. It's trying to look after you, not in the best possible way, but it is genuinely trying to look after you. So don't beat yourself up. It's not your fault. Okay? So then, first of all, watch that you're eating properly, breakfast, lunch, dinner, because if you're hungry, you're hungry. Make sure that you drink enough as well, because again, as I just mentioned, if you're thirsty, your body will feel that you're hungry. So make sure that you drink enough. And then watch your energy level. So if you feel stressed, if you feel bored, that's when the tendency to look for food comes up. So do something about it. Tackle the energy problem with something else than food. So I gave you the idea of the suggestion of that sequence. But if you want to go for a walk, if you want to dance about, if you want to do something creative, you know, anything that will raise your energy, but without you having to look for food. Okay? So those are the main points from today. So as I said, as soon as I finish this, I'm going to record the little sequence. And then I'll post it on YouTube and I'll send you the link. I'll post the link in the group so that you'll be able to go and look it up and maybe practice it as and when you feel like it. Okay? Wishing you a lovely day, and I'll see you next week. Take care. Bye bye.